next, you'll discover how to build and deploy applications with Compute Engine. Compute Engine delivers virtual machines running in Google's innovative data centers and worldwide fiber network. Compute Engine is ideal if you need complete control over the virtual machine infrastructure, need to make changes to the kernel, such as providing your own network or graphics drivers to squeeze out the last drop of performance, or if you need to run a software package that can't easily be containerized or have existing VM images to move to the cloud. Compute Engine is a type of infrastructure as a service. It delivers scalable, high-performance virtual machines that run on Google's infrastructure. Compute Engine VMs boot quickly, come with persistent disk storage, and deliver consistent performance. You can run any computing workload on Compute Engine, such as web server hosting, and application backends. Virtual servers are available in many configurations, including predefined sizes. Alternatively, there's the option to create custom machine types optimized for specific needs. Compute Engine also allows users to run their choice of operating system. And while Compute Engine allows users to run thousands of virtual CPUs on a system that has been designed to be fast and offer strong performance consistency, there's no upfront investment required. The purpose of custom virtual machines is to ensure you can create virtual services with just enough resources to work for your application. For example, you want to run your application on a virtual machine, but none of the predefined versions will fit the resource footprint you require. Or your application needs to run on a specific CPU architecture, or GPUs are required to run your application. Custom virtual machines allow for creating a perfect fit for your applications. To meet your workload requirements, there are different machine type options that you can consider. For example, a higher proportion of memory to CPU, a higher proportion of CPU to memory, or a blend of both through Google's standard configuration. Compute Engine offers predefined machine types that you can use when you create an instance. A predefined machine type has a preset number of virtual CPUs, or vCPUs, and amount of memory, and are charged at a set price. You can choose from the general purpose machine types, memory optimized machine types, and compute optimized machine types. Predefined virtual machine configurations range from micro instances of 2 vCPUs and 8 gigabytes of memory to memory optimized instances with up to 160 vCPUs and 3.75 terabytes of memory. Compute Engine also allows you to create virtual machines with the vCPU and memory that meet workload requirements. This has performance benefits and also reduces costs significantly. One option is to select from predefined configurations. A general purpose configuration provides a balance between performance and memory. Or you can optimize for memory or for performance. You can create a machine type with as little as 1 vCPU and up to 80 vCPUs, or any even number of vCPUs in between. You can configure up to 8 gigabytes of memory per vCPU. Alternatively, if none of the predefined virtual machines fit your needs, you have the option to create a custom virtual machine. When you create a custom virtual machine, you can choose the number of CPUs, the amount of memory required, the CPU architecture to leverage, and the option of using GPUs. Network storage, up to 64 terabytes in size, can be attached to VMs as persistent disks. Persistent disks are the most common storage option due to their price, performance, and durability, and can be created in HDD or SSD formats. If a VM instance is terminated, its persistent disk retains data and can be attached to another instance. You can also take snapshots of your persistent disk and create new persistent disks from that snapshot. Compute Engine offers always encrypted local SSD block storage. Unlike standard persistent disks, local SSDs are physically attached to the server hosting the VM instance, offering very high input-output operations per second and very low latency compared to persistent disks. Predefined local SSD sizes up to 3 terabytes are available for any VM with at least one vCPU. By default, most Compute Engine-provided Linux images will automatically run an optimization script that configures the instance for peak local SSD performance. Standard persistent disk performance scales linearly up to the VM performance limits. A vCPU count of 4 or more for your instance doesn't limit the performance of standard persistent disks. A vCPU count of less than 4 for an instance reduces the write limit for input-output operations per second, or IOPS, because network egress limits are proportional to the vCPU count. The write limit also depends on the size of input-outputs, or IOs. For example, 16-kilobyte IOs consume more bandwidth than 8-kilobyte IOs at the same IOPS level. Standard persistent disk IOPS and throughput performance increase linearly with the size of the disk until it reaches set per instance limits. The IOPS performance of SSD persistent disks depends on the number of vCPUs in the instance, in addition to disk size. Lower core VMs have lower write IOPS and throughput limits due to the network egress limitations on write throughput. SSD persistent disk performance scales linearly until it reaches either the limits of the volume or the limits of each Compute Engine instance. SSD read bandwidth and IOPS consistency near the maximum limits largely depends on network ingress utilization. Some variability is to be expected, especially for 16 kilobyte IOs near the maximum IOPS limits. Networks connect Compute Engine instances to each other and to the internet. Networks in the cloud have a lot of similarities with physical networks. You can segment networks, use firewall rules to restrict access to instances, and create static routes to forward traffic to specific destinations. You can scale up applications on Compute Engine from zero to full throttle with cloud load balancing. Distribute your load-balanced compute resources in single or multiple regions close to your users and to meet your high availability requirements. Subnetworks segment your cloud network IP space. Subnetwork prefixes can be automatically allocated, or you can create a custom topology. Subnetworks and cloud load balancing are both discussed in the module, It Helps to Network. When you build a Compute Engine instance, you use a virtual network adapter, which is part of the instance, to connect a virtual machine to a network, much in the same way you would connect a physical server to a network. For Compute Engine, you can have up to 8 virtual adapters. Subnetworks and cloud load balancing are both discussed in the module, It Helps to Network. All virtual machines are charged for 1 minute at boot time, which is the minimum charge for a VM. After that, per second pricing begins, meaning that you only pay for the compute time used. Google offers sustained use discounts, which automatically provide discounted prices for long-running workloads without the need for sign-up fees or any upfront commitment. Predefined machine types are discounted based on the percent of monthly use, while custom machine types are discounted on a percent of total use. The GCP pricing calculator is a great way to see pricing estimates based on the different configuration options that are available under instances, sole tenant nodes, persistent disks, load balancing, and cloud TPUs.